You're listening to Mr. Radio, and I'm your host, Marshall.
Now let's reach into the vaults for an original Mr. Radio.
Bergen Community College presents This is Bergen. Today's program will feature an interview with Arista recording artist Sarah McLachlan. Good afternoon, this is Lisa Fondo. Today we have a special program. I had the opportunity to interview Sarah McLachlan, a new artist on Arista Records, a few weeks ago. I'd like to mention that, just before I run the interview, keep in mind, this interview was conducted in a dressing room, backstage, while another performer was playing upstairs and people were running around outside the door. So if at times you hear some unusual background noise, keep that in mind. This was not done in the studio. Thanks a lot. I hope you enjoy it. And now, on to the interview with Sarah. Good afternoon. This is Lisa Fondo from WRPR-FM. Today I have a very special guest, Sarah McLachlan, Arista's newest recording artist. She has a new album out called Touch, which you will be hearing quite a bit of in the next few minutes, and I'm sure you will be hearing a lot about in the near future. Sarah, thanks for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome, Sarah. Well, I have to tell you that I haven't heard a new album from a new artist in a long time that has really moved me as much. I think that your sound is very, very unique, and I think our audience would be very interested in hearing a little about your background. How did you actually come to be on the shores so soon at such a young age?
Well, I guess I should tell you the story from the beginning.
Why don't you do that?
Okay. Well, when I was 17 in Halifax, Nova Scotia, I was in a band called The October Game, and we opened for Mauve, which was then the basis of Network, an independent record company in Vancouver, Canada. And Mark Jowett, who is now the head of A&R for Network, at the time was a guitar player in the band, and he heard me sing and wanted me to do some demos for Mauve in Vancouver. And my parents were not too pleased when I told them about it, so that didn't happen. But my guitar player kept in touch with Network over the next 2 years. And when I was 19, in May, I had finished a year of art college, and I was working at the Club Flamingo in Halifax, and Skinny Puppy came to town with Terry McBride, who's the president of Network, and he asked to speak to me and offered me a 5-record contract out of the blue. So it was kind of an amazing thing. And I thought about it for 3 months, and I accepted it.
The 3 months that you were thinking about it, were you just going over all the pros and cons? Were you having major discussions with your family and worrying? Or?
Well, actually, I didn't mention it to my family until I was certain that I was going to do it, because there was no sense in causing an amazing amount of stress if I decided not to do it, which it would have. So, and it did, when I did tell them. But yes, I was weighing out the pros and cons. I asked everybody I knew if they knew what they knew about Network, and basically it was all good. And I talked, and I got a lawyer and talked over the contract with them. And everything seemed really good, so I took the contract and moved to Vancouver in September.
And how did you start about writing your songs? I mean, I know I've read in your bio that you hadn't actually written a lot of songs before. Why don't you tell us about that experience?
Well, actually, when I got to Vancouver, I had never written a whole song before. And I began to write one in late August, before I had moved to Vancouver, and that was Out of the Shadows, which happens to be the first song on the album, which got finished after I got to Vancouver. It was a lot of trial and error and hit and miss with writing, because I'd never done it before. I wanted to come up with something unique, and it took a long time weeding out the good stuff from the bad stuff, and mulling over parts and working out other parts to go along with them. And each song probably took about 4 months to complete. I'd lose all my objectivity. I'd be working and working and working on a song, and I'd go crazy with it because I wasn't coming up with anything, so I'd have to leave it and go back to it later. Again, I'd always be writing something else in the meantime. Mm-hmm. But there was a lot of different processes involved, just getting a part, doing something else over it, throwing out the first part, doing a new part over it, and working and working and working, and finally coming out with a finished product, which was, it took a while, but it happened.
Okay, well, I think right now we're going to play Out of the Shadows. This is from Touch on Arista.
Down inside.
Okay, well, we're back. So, Sarah, why don't you tell us a little bit about your band? Are they musicians that you've played with a lot in the past? I know this is really your first solid band of your own. Did you put an ad in the paper, or did you wear these old friends, or how?
Well, the basis of the band, which is me and then Darren Phillips, who was with me pretty much from the beginning as a keyboard player, who helped me a lot with writing and recording of the album, and he's still with me. And Stephen DeCleva, who plays some guitar on the album, he's with me now. And a rhythm section from Edmonton. Actually, I got all these people via network. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know anybody when I moved out, and so everybody I know came from Network to help me. And they were not necessarily Network artists, but they were people affiliated somehow. They'd played on somebody's record and whatnot.
Network.
So, yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and the rhythm section actually is Jeff Cross and Sherry Lee. Sherry Lee plays drums. And Jeff Cross on bass, and he's accompanying me on this promotional tour I'm doing right now.
Why don't you tell us a little about the tour? When and where will you be playing? When will the American audiences be able to find you?
Well, this time around it's only a promotional tour. I'm doing a few in stores, and I'm doing a lot of industry things, going into the warehouses and meeting all the people and doing a few songs for them. And I think the real tour with the band is going to take place, I think, in late June. And we'll go through all the states and play.
Okay, listening to the album myself, I found that it was very unique, and the style is different. And I think I mentioned this to you a little earlier, that I could picture you in the 17th century or Renaissance periods singing madrigals. You have that type of a voice, but it really is the type of sound which a lot of people, a very wide audience, can appreciate. The next question I'd like to ask you, I know that you're just starting to do some videos. What videos have you done for what songs?
I just finished the second video for Vox. The first one was done in late November for the Canadian release of the album. And with the Arista release, I got the opportunity to do it again, more to the way I wanted to do it, because the first one sort of got done in a hurry, and it didn't have what I wanted in it. And luckily, wonderfully enough, I got the opportunity to do it again, so I did it more the way I wanted it done, which needed a bigger budget, because I wanted to go to the desert to shoot it, and we ended up going to the desert, and we did it in L.A., and northern, I guess it was more Southern California, it was in the desert, Joshua Tree National Park, and I'm not sure where a lot of the location was just out. It was out on a lake bed. It was very desolate and very, you could see mirages all over the place. It was very hot.
I can imagine, right. Mm-hmm.
So will we be able to see that on the television, on MTV and various video shows soon?
Oh, I hope so, yes. I believe it's going to be out probably in about a week and a half. I saw close to a final edit today. So probably in about a week and a half it should be out on MTV and VH1.
Okay, great. So we're going to play Vox right now, and everyone should be on the lookout. And, of course, just buy the album. If you buy the album, you can hear every single song that we're talking about. And we don't have time to play them all, but these are some of the best. Okay, right now, Vox from Sarah McLachlan.
Thank you.
Okay, Sarah, I know that you have an incredibly hectic schedule. You're running around like crazy. And before we close out, why don't you tell us a little about your feelings so far as about New York and the touring, and just, it's a crazy experience for you, I'm sure. In fact, I'm sure you really can talk about it, but why don't you try?
Well, there's so many things to say.
How do you like New York City?
I love New York. The first time I came here, I was very sick, and I didn't enjoy it very much because I think I took it out on New York because I was sick, and it really wasn't its fault. But now
it'll be glad to hear that, yeah?
Yes, well... Now that I'm back again, after I left, I realized this is a wonderful city. It's terrifying and it's wonderful at the same time. And I'm from a very small city myself, and it was quite overwhelming for me to be in such a huge city.
That's Nova Scotia is where you're from?
Halifax? Yeah.
Nova Scotia. Okay.
And it's about 300,000 people. And I do live in Vancouver now in Canada and BC, which is well over a million, but it's still not the same as this. And I love it. I think it's amazing. I don't think I'd want to live here. It's too much for me.
It's overwhelming.
That, and I need the ocean. I have to be near the ocean. But
do you do any salmon fishing or anything? I mean, that's what it's known for.
Believe it or not, I've never fished in my life. Coming from an international harbor, I've never fished before. But I do love water. I love the ocean and its soothing qualities.
What did you think about Los Angeles?
Well, it was horribly hot and muggy. And the smog is terrible, but there were interesting qualities about it as well. The people there were wonderful, really nice, as well as they are here.
You've met nice people in New York?
Yes.
Oh, they must be tourists.
Well, this is, people say that New York isn't that friendly. I found it very friendly so far. I mean, people, you bump into somebody on the street and they don't swear at you, they say, "I'm sorry."
They're definitely tourists.
Really? Well, I guess I've been on the right side of the town or something.
Yeah, I think so.
So anyway, when will you be heading back to British Columbia?
Well, tomorrow morning early I go to Atlanta, Georgia, and the next day I go to Raleigh, North Carolina, and then I head back to Vancouver on Friday, I believe.
Okay, and I understand you will be playing a few dates there first, right, before you embark on your European tour.
Yes, well, the Saturday morning I get back, and the Saturday evening I play a gig, and then Sunday night I fly out to Halifax, which is 4,000 miles away. I'm sort of hosting the Maritime Music Awards there. I'm nominated for four things.
So. Oh, congratulations.
Well, thank you. And I get one glorious day in Halifax, and then I'm back to Vancouver because I've got all of 8 days to practice for the American tour, or the Canadian tour, excuse me. And I'm playing two gigs on the 17th and 18th, which are the Friday and Saturday night at the Town Pump in Vancouver, and then I'm off on the Canadian tour.
Well, I wish you the best of luck. I've really enjoyed having you, and I really love the album, and I certainly wish you all the best. Okay, we're going to close out this little interview with the title song, Touch, from the self-titled Touch, Sarah McLachlan on Arista Records. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you for joining us, and good luck to you.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
And here we go with Touch. Thank you. Lisa Fondo again, WRPR-FM 89.3. If you've just joined us, you've missed a very good interview. I just completed interviewing Sarah McLachlan, a new artist on Arista Records, and we had the pleasure of listening to a few of her songs. I really do suggest that you go out and buy the album. The music, as you have been able to garner, I'm sure, from the few songs I played for you, is really very different, very unique. And with the many new women artists that we hear right now, I think Sarah McLachlan really stands out, even at the young age that she is. She's only 21. This is her first band. And she actually was quite candid when I asked her about writing some songs. She said she had never written any songs before. So for a first effort, this is really outstanding. She should be back in the United States, in the New York area, I believe sometime in June or July. But keep your eyes posted on the newspapers and even right here, I suppose, if we get any information, we may be able to pass it on to you. I think that Sarah's sound is indicative of a slight change toward music right now. We've gotten involved in so many different areas. For a while there, we had so much, well, I won't say typical music, but I think that we were in a pretty much hard rock era, and this is such a change of pace and such a refreshing change of pace. I mean, of course, we have so many other wonderful artists, and there are many great women artists as well who are coming to the fore, and I for one, am very happy to hear that. But as far as Sarah McLachlan, I really do suggest you see her. The interview that we actually had took place in a small club. It was part of a promotional tour, and I had the opportunity to see her live. So I am speaking from experience, and of course everyone has their own taste, but I was very impressed. So, enough said. You've had an afternoon with Sarah McLachlan. I hope you have the opportunity to see her. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. This is Bergen is produced by the broadcasting students of Bergen Community College in association with WRPR-FM. Today's program featured an interview with Sarah McLachlan. This is Bergen was produced by Lisa Fondo and directed by Lisa Fondo and Gary Hayden. Location interview assisted by Catherine Harris. We'd like to hear from you. Send your comments to This is Bergen, Bergen Community College, room A331, 400 Paramus Road, Paramus, New Jersey, 07652. This is Lisa Fondo speaking.
Listening to Mr. Radio, and I'm your host, Marshall. This program was written and produced by Marshall. Our theme music was played by Ululation. Mr. Radio is available wherever you get your podcasts, including iTunes and Spotify. Subscribe to our podcast and leave us a review. And don't forget to tune in next week for another episode of Mr. Radio.